Welcome to this video tutorial, Mechanical Ventilators 101. Ventilators can be quite overwhelming, so let's take a look at some of the basics. Mechanical ventilation is a means to mechanically assist or replace spontaneous respiration. It is indicated for patients who are apneic, they're not breathing, or they're breathing ineffectively, causing ventilation problems. Mechanical ventilation is used to help the patient ventilate and oxygenate, with the end goal being to wean before complications arise. Mechanical ventilation can be provided noninvasively by face or nasal mask, or by an invasive airway, intubation. Noninvasive mechanical ventilation requires an alert, cooperative, and hemodynamically stable patient. Ventilation is delivered by a CPAP or BiPAP device by way of a face or nasal mask. CPAP is continuous positive airway pressure. It provides a constant end expiratory pressure that keeps the airway open, providing supplemental oxygen if needed. Whether breathing in or out, the continuous pressure keeps the alveoli open and the tongue forward, preventing sleep apnea. BiPAP is bi-level positive airway pressure, similar to CPAP, but it delivers different levels of pressure during inspiration and expiration. If the patient is not a candidate for noninvasive ventilation, or if it is not providing adequate ventilation, then the patient would require intubation, which is invasive mechanical ventilation. Intubation is achieved with an endotracheal tube, or ETT, or a tracheostomy, commonly called a trach. ET tubes are inserted into the trachea through the mouth or nose. Oral intubation is preferred and more common due to an increased risk of pneumonia and sinus infections with nasal intubation. ET tubes can be left in place for several weeks, but after 10 to 14 days, tracheostomy is considered. A tracheostomy is an artificial opening in the trachea into which a tracheostomy tube is inserted. There are two basic types of ventilators available: pressure-cycled ventilators and volume-cycled ventilators. Volume-cycled ventilators are used most frequently. They deliver a constant volume of air with each breath. Pressure-cycled ventilators deliver a volume of gas to the airway using positive pressure during inspiration. Once the set pressure has been reached, the machine cycles off and exhalation occurs passively. Our focus will be on volume-cycled ventilators since they are used more frequently. We will be looking at three basic ventilator modes: assist control, or AC, which is a full support; synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, or SIMV, which is an intermediate mode; and pressure support ventilation, or PSV, which is the stepping stone to extubation. Assist control, or AC, mode is the most common ventilator mode used in the ICU. The AC mode is a full support mode. Every breath is a positive pressure ventilator breath, but it can be initiated by the machine or the patient. The patient receives a mandatory rate, the respiratory rate, and a mandatory volume, the tidal volume. The benefit of the assist control mode is that it decreases the work of breathing. It can be used for patients who have some spontaneous breathing and those who don't. It provides the set number of breaths every minute, but also allows the patient to initiate breaths on their own, decreasing anxiety. The disadvantage of the AC mode is that due to the low work of breathing, the respiratory muscles weaken. It can cause breath stacking, where air never fully exits the alveoli before another breath is taken. Every breath is the same size, and if the patient wants larger breaths than the set tidal volume, it can cause anxiety, leading to tachypnea and hyperventilation. SIMV, or synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, is another common mode used in the ICU. It's often used also in surgical patients requiring ventilator support for a short time post-op. It uses a set number of breaths delivered each minute, but the patient can breathe as often as he feels the need to. The ventilator breaths are synchronized with the patient's spontaneous breaths. The ventilator breaths deliver the full tidal volume, but the patient-initiated breaths require the patient to inhale the tidal volume independently. This helps work the respiratory muscles by providing periods of decreased support, and the rate can be turned down so the patient can start to be weaned. Ventilator breaths are synchronized with the patient's spontaneous breaths. The ventilator breaths deliver the full tidal volume, but patient-initiated breaths require the patient to inhale the tidal volume independently. PSV, or pressure support ventilation, can be used alone or with SIMV. This provides a small amount of pressure during inspiration to help the patient take in a spontaneous breath. The patient regulates his own respiratory rate and tidal volume, and pressure support provides a constant end expiratory pressure that keeps the alveoli open, providing supplemental oxygen if needed. This mode is used as a stepping stone between a dependent ventilator mode and extubation because it reduces the work of breathing for the patient. We will be covering four basic ventilator settings: respiratory rate, tidal volume, fractional inspiration of oxygen, and peak end expiratory pressure. Tidal volume, or TV, is the amount of air going into a patient's lungs with each breath, usually set between 400 to 800 milliliters based on body weight. FiO2 stands for fractional inspiration of oxygen, the percentage of oxygen concentration going into the lungs required to maintain adequate blood oxygen levels. PEEP is the positive end expiratory pressure. This is the amount of pressure left in the circuit at the end of exhalation. It helps keep the alveoli open, allowing for better oxygenation, and is usually set between 5 to 10 centimeters of water. Ventilator alarms. Anytime an alarm goes off, always look at your patient first. Do not immediately silence the alarm. We need to figure out why the ventilator is alarming. Alarm systems vary between machines, but there are two basic alarms. The high pressure alarm shows increased resistance somewhere in the system. Equipment obstruction, patient obstruction, coughing or secretions, or water condensation in the tubing. The low pressure alarm is a leak in the system, a disconnection somewhere, so check all of your connections. Troubleshoot the alarm, starting with the patient and moving toward the machine. Prolonged mechanical ventilation is dangerous and expensive, with the occurrence of pneumonia increasing each day the patient remains on the ventilator. Certain criteria must be met for weaning of the ventilator to be initiated. The patient must have acceptable ABGs and normal hematocrit. The patient must be breathing on their own with a tidal volume greater than 10 milliliters per kilogram. Their FiO2 should be less than 0.5. Room air is 0.21 or 21% oxygen. They should have an intact gag reflex with the ability to cough and take in a deep breath. And they should have adequate inspiratory pressure, which is the ability to suck air into their lungs. Let's go over a basic review of what we've discussed today. There are two basic non-invasive ventilator modes, CPAP, or continuous positive airway pressure, and BiPAP, bi-level positive airway pressure. And then three basic invasive ventilator modes, AC, or assist control, which is our full support, SIMV, which is synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, that's our intermediate mode, and PSV, or pressure support ventilation, which is the last step before extubating. And we have four basic settings: our respiratory rate, tidal volume, fractional inspiration of oxygen, and positive end expiratory pressure. Thank you for watching this video tutorial on mechanical ventilators, and be sure to subscribe to our channel and like us on Facebook.